Hi. In this session, we will see how to work with circular path. The same one, in some interviews they will ask, without using loop, how to go for a loop. Let me create a process for this. Circular. Now, the requirement for this is, let me explain with some scenario. When you swipe any of your credit card, when you are swiping, you will have a swipe amount. Plus, you will have unbilled amount. It means previous swiped amount. Swipe amount plus unbilled amount, it should be less than or equal to your credit limit, right? This is the scenario. Until your transaction reaches this condition, you can keep on using your card. You can swipe your card. Once it reaches this condition, then it will stop there. Right? This is circular path or iterations. Now the same example, let's try with some minimum value and maximum value conditions. Now this is a minimum value data type. Number, initial value, you can take it as a zero, and then maximum value, another data item, let's take max value as 9, click OK. Now, every time when you are doing some calculation, it has to increment by 1. It means minimum value plus 1. And it will store it in a same minimum value. So every time it will store the same value. And then this calculation has to stop when your minimum value reaches maximum value. It means we can use this by using decision. Decision condition will be minimum value less than maximum, right? Okay. When it comes to this condition, it has to stop if it is true. Minimum value less than maximum, then it has to go. If it is not, then it has to stop. For that, we can use anchor. Observe this. How we are giving. If it is yes, go and do the calculation again. If it is not, then end the process. Now let's assume this is, so maximum amount is your credit limit. So this is your minimum amount. Every time when you are swiping, it will increment by 1, right? And then observe this condition, how it is going to be. See this? 1, it increased. Next loop, again, this is going for a loop, right? But we are not using any loop shape here. Without using a loop shape also, we can achieve the loop. This particular thing, we are going to call it as a circular path. When it reaches this condition, then it will stop the process. Like when your credit limit is not available, then it will stop your process. It means it will decline your transaction, right? In these scenarios, we are going to use this kind of circular path. Thank you.